everybody. Welcome back to the shop. For my last episode tonight, I'm going to make an action. Yeah, it's about 12:30. You know, I get started too late, and this thing's leading to late at night. And...
we did it a little bit today, but we had some fun.
And that tomcat is a beast. You cannot wake a fly that thing. There's just something about flying something that powerful. You know, there's nothing worse than an underpowered jet, number one. You know, that's just terrible. I remember them ducking feds, come on, baby, do that first turn. Just mushing it through that first turn. That tomcat's going to hit the end of the runway and go, oh, I can't wait. But anyway, okay. I got my cardboard on there. See what I did? It's getting kind of sticky now. This is building up a lot of heat. Resin's, you know, drying faster. So, I put that cardboard on there. Bend it where I want it. Put a little weight on it. Then I come in the bottom half, you know, and just kind of put a little cloth on there in that corner, leading out onto this flange, kind of glass it all over the place. Let it set up for a little bit to work. It'll stay without that weight. It's not completely set up, but that mold's hot. You can feel the heat coming off of it. She's setting up fast. And I found it was easier if you just spread that cloth on some wax paper rather than trying to do it on this. That heavy cloth soaks up so much resin. You guys watching? Okay.
I'm go ahead and gonna put the resin on my cardboard in the area under where they join. I want to fill up the cavities a little bit with some resin. Enough. I want this strong enough to where if all this cardboard gets wet and washes away, the fiberglass will be fine. The only place is just right there. That's really not that big an issue. By the time I get a couple layers of this 40 ounce on there, that lip's on there forever. I don't care what happens to that cardboard. Soak this stuff down here, because it's not easy to do on that cardboard. You know what I mean there, Vern? Man, I know y'all just sitting back singing that Danger Zone song. Oh, come on, tell us the truth. Now, see, I'm going to overlap it onto that flange and just butt the rest of it. Like so. I really just want, and I'm going to put some more of this 10 ounce on that lip or in the corner. Okay.
And I want to make that flange. I want that flange about a quarter inch thick.
No kidding. I do not want these molds warping everything. I think my mold warping days is came to an end. I got the stuff figured out now. You know what I mean? Okay. Now, lay this resin on there thick, man. Let it soak in. Let
see. Can you see?
Can you see, said the clock? Yeah, I know y'all have been walking around singing that Danger Zone. Just sitting back ready for that tomcat to burn two holes in the sky. Oh, I am. I think me and Balcom's going to go out Saturday or Sunday. We're talking about maybe getting the Hornet out. I'm laying the pressure on him. Time for old Balcom to quit loafing. Don't you guys think? Come on, man. Let's get together and get old Balcom out there. Come on. Let's hear it, everybody. He watches every one of these videos, people. Come on. Let's see if we can get a worldwide cheer for old Balcom to get out some jets. It's time to play with some fire. Sets up and be like steel. That's what you want. You know? This set a couple days, might get the old Thunder Chief out, get it put back together. You gotta know me, man. My stuff's gotta be ready to fly. I can't, you know what I mean? It's in pieces, believe it or not. Oh, yeah, I got. I got the script down. I got the parts to fix it. Got everything I need. Dent gear is going up. Okay, now that's enough of that. And I got a bunch of these pieces cut like this. We'll come out here, go like that, just to connect them real good. And build up my flange, this flange. The more I build that up, the better. See, there's lots of resin there. Don't need to cook that much. That's how you build a production mold. You've seen it right here on Bob TV.